Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Creatnprocess. In this video, we're working on this graphic design. So on top layer, we have got a basic shape of an alphabet A. And below that, we have got a multiple number of layers with our drop shadow effects being applied. And it has got three shades of colors which are being applied simultaneously. So let's begin the tutorial. We'll start our design with the star tool. So I'll select the star tool from our palette here and left click your mouse button here, give the points 3 and click OK. So you got a triangle, nice triangle here. Just remove the fill color and the, let's give stroke color and like that, and let's rotate this to 180 degrees. So rotating that, scale this up and let's do some adjustments. So let's just scale this from sideways equally. So to do that, just click with the alt press. Just make sure you scale it down and you got this shape, nice shape. Now once you have done that, let's increase the stroke thickness to our desired requirement, and I think this we can just play around. Let's skip 20 and enter. So we got this. Now let's cut this off from here, we don't need this low one. So I use the seize tool and cut and cut. So we have cut down the lower piece, delete it out, and we got this shape. Now once you got this, we can just make sure it's one object. So go to object, path and outline stroke, and using the pathfinder just combine it, and this way we got make this fill object. Now next thing is we have to do maintain the shape. So to do that, I'll use the rectangle tool and draw one shape rectangle, and let's fill this out with the stroke color. And now we'll just make sure it's placed around here, one, and this one below one, we'll place this around here. Okay, now once you got this, we'll just duplicate this, Control C or Command C or Command F, and you paste it on the front. Now scale this down and place it around here. Now select everything, use the shape builder tool and make sure this is one object. So I'll just choose one color from here, maybe blue, and let's click and make sure it's one object, and the rest just select this and delete it out. So select it all, delete, delete and delete. So we got this one, only one shape. Now we have to make sure to make that inner piece like the alphabet A. So we'll use the rectangle tool and draw out a small piece of rectangle with a thin width. So make sure we place it in the proper place. Okay, so and if we zoom it in, we can just reduce the thickness a little bit more. So I'll just select this and reduce it a little bit more. So let's zoom it out and let's see. Okay, that's looking great. Just select that, pathfinder, combine it, and it's now one object. Next thing we need to do is we need to create that multiple number of layers. To create that, we'll duplicate this and we'll use the layer palette. So I'll just drag this layer palette out here, and you can see here's the layer palette. What we can do is we can just click on this triangle and here's the object. I'll just create one layer, new layer, and just click and drag and drop over there. And this one I'll just place it. So this is the layer where we're working on, and here's our main layer. Now let's duplicate this. So Control C or Command F, and you'll duplicate it one more. You can see on the layer, select the lower one and let's give some stroke thickness. So let's give around, let's say 18, let's see. Okay, that's great. You can play around with the thickness anytime. For this, let's keep it around 18 or maybe 19, let's see. Okay, that's great. So let's select that and now go to object, path and convert this into outline stroke, and after that let's combine it. Now in the same way, I'll just duplicate this one more time and select the lower layer, give some stroke thickness, let's give how much, 19, and enter, and we got that thickness. Go to object, path and outline stroke, and then combine it. So we have got all separate layers here. So let's give now draw effect to this layer. So select each and every layer. So I'll just select this one, and go to effect, stylize, drop shadow, and let's see the effect preview. And let's play around with the position of the shadows. Okay, so let's see, we have given -5 here, and we can give the opacity to around maybe say 90, and let's see. Okay, let's skip that. Now let's select the upper layer, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow. This time let's apply the same effects. So we got that nice dark effect here, and let's see if I increase this. Okay, -6 is also good. So you can give that, selecting this, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow, and preview. So yeah, click OK, select the top layer, go to effect, stylize, drop shadow, preview. Yeah, that's nice. We can reduce this a little bit here. Now let's give 85 and click OK. And now the top layer, so we got that effect, stylize, drop shadow, let's apply, preview it. Okay, we got that nice shadow there, and click OK. So we have applied everything. We'll select the lower layer and let's apply some drop shadow here also. So effect, stylize, drop shadow, preview it. Okay, and we can just reduce the distance here. So for now let's give -2 and blur effect, let's give it 1. And now if we check it out, we have got that nice shadows there. And let's apply the proper color now. So I just select the top layer with the eye picker selected. I just select this color. Now selecting the lower layer with the eye picker, select this second color. Select the third layer with the eye picker, select the yellow color. Select the fourth layer with the eye picker, select that color again. Selecting that, select this, selecting that, select this. So we had applied the color and we applied the shadows. So now we have designed this effects and everything in Illustrator. Now let's work out on Photoshop, giving some new effects and working out with the perspective and adding the text. So I'll just select this and let's export this out. So let's export this out. I just place this around here, and with using that artboard, I'll just create a new artboard and just export this out. So go to file, save for web, make sure it's PNG. Okay, and let's increase it to 500 and save. Now we'll just drag into Photoshop. So I'll just open the folder and just click and drag in there. So we got our alphabet A here. We can just click and drag and drop to our main file, MD file, and let's open the layers. So here's our layer file and this is our object here. So let's convert this into a smart object, convert the smart object, and now let's work out with our object. So I'll just Control T to transform, and let's click the distort option and let's distort the perspective. So and enter. So we have given some perspective view here, and we can even play around with the color code. So we can just go around and let's give some effect here. So I'll use the brightness and contrast here. Let's give some contrasting colors here, so we can just make it a little bit eye-catchy and sharp using the brightness and contrast effects. You can see that, and let's add the text. So I'll use the text tool and type out our text for this white color, S-E-R-I-E-S series, and this one let's choose the proper font color. So let's choose the font from here. So we got the text here. Well, you choose this text and let's play around with the perspective. So Control D, let's scale this a little bit and distort. or maybe before that, let's convert this into smart object. So selecting that, convert to smart object. Now Control T, and you can now distort that. So distort option selected, let's zoom it in and let's use the perspective view. So let's change this and enter. So we have placed that, and if you want to give a little effects here, you can do that. We can select, go to layer, double click on that, and let's give some effect. So let's see, we'll choose a inner shadow like that, and let's give some distance and reduce the size, and let's distance, and let's change the angle. Okay, and let's see, reduce the distance. Okay, so let's see 2, and increase the opacity a little bit, just reduce it and click okay. And now let's zoom it out, and you can see we have got a nice effect there. Now let's lock this background, and now overall you can select and Control D, and now you can just scale it up and down and place it according to your design like that, and here it is. So finally we have completed our design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you're not recent on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Also don't forget to check out our website for new updates and new articles on design. Thank you.